In all great cities, the past still coexists with the present. But in Rome, more than anywhere else, the ancient world still has a massive influence over the modern. And what a rich and enduring history that is. I'm Ray Lawrence. I'm a professor of Roman history and archaeology at the University of Kent, and I've created this programme in Roman history and archaeology which takes the students to Rome for a semester. 20 years ago, I came and it changed who I was and the way I saw the city of Rome. So, here we've got Rostra, right? So we've got height.
It has always been my ambition to share that amazing experience with a new generation of students. Imagine being able to study ancient history and Roman history and archaeology for a one-year MA where you spend a whole term in Rome visiting the sites, museums and libraries right in the heart of the Eternal City.
I studied for an archaeology and classical history degree whilst working full-time. It was whilst I was writing my dissertation that I realised pursuing an academic career looking at the ancient world was what I really wanted to do with my life.
I'm studying Roman history and archaeology, and for me, why study this topic anywhere else but in the city of Rome? The added benefit of this course is that you have the support of two institutions, so you have Kent and the American University. And you also have access to all of the Roman sites, museums, and the many libraries.
One of the advantages of actually being in Rome is that we can take material from a lecture or a library and go to see it on site. Today, we're in the Forum, the centre of the city, and the place where so much happened 2,000 years ago. People came here for business, but also for fun. The students have been searching and finding some of the 130 or so game boards scratched onto the steps and pavement of the Forum.
So this one says
O-R-P-I-X.
You'd think they'd be maybe located more by a column where...
Or are you just out the way of the steps?
I think it just really changes your perspective. If you've been studying Rome for a long period of time, you're used to looking at it in books, you're used to looking at maps and descriptions, and so you sort of, you piece it together from all of the things that you've read. But of course, being here, it's going to change that drastically. And having walked around today, it's amazing, you know, just Ray can point to one thing, but like, well, this is not in situ, this was taken from here.
It's fantastic because I'm looking at doing a PhD at Kent and I'm going to do them on the Tiber bridges, and straight away being here you can see a lot about the bridges, the flow of the water, how close they are, which you just can't get from a book, and it really gives you a sense again of the size and the width of the bridges.
We are going to go on to Tiber Island, then we're going to go across the other bridge and then come head back towards the Quercumatum.
More than 90% of Kent's postgraduates either find a job or go on to further studies within 6 months. And studying in a foreign country definitely increases your chances of finding the job that you want.
The master's course is about research skills, and this trains people. So when they start a PhD, let's say in a year's time, where we've given them a scholarship and they're really working for that 3 years on the big project, they have a head start because they know how to do it. They're comfortable with coming to Rome. They will then produce further work which will be of interest out of the programme. Again, having the statue of Castor and Pollux there, and we're going to go past the Temple of Pompey, the Theatre of Pompey, and that whole area.
At the end of 12 months, you will have an internationally recognised qualification, and you can show any employer how you can rise to the challenge and live and work in an international environment
Capite tutti l'espressione rompere il ghiaccio?
Kent offers a language as part of their program, so I'm studying Italian. I really couldn't have achieved the same level of motivation and enthusiasm for my topic without being inspired by walking in the streets. In this city, when you close a book, you don't stop learning. Walking down the street may reveal something to you it had not the day before. For me, this is the magic of the city of Rome.